Hey everybody, today we're gonna see how we can use the brush tool, which is included in the updated disintegration plugin from Pixel Film Studios. Don't forget to like this video and subscribe for more content like this one. I'm gonna show you three examples. The first two are gonna be easy ones, and on the third one, it's gonna be a more complicated but much more awesome look. So let's go into Final Cut Pro 10 and check the brush tool in action. All right, we're in the Final Cut Pro 10 and we have the images that we will apply the Emit Disintegrate effect using the new brush tool that we have in the Pixel Film Studios Disintegrate plugin. As you can see here, I have placed the image and I already have placed the Disintegrate Dual Brush layer that you can find on your layers, and here where it says Disintegrate Dual Brush, I'm gonna drag it and place it above. Now, the thing that we're gonna do first, we're going into the beginning of the image, and as you can see here in the Inspector panel, we can click here to enable the brush edit mode. Let me just clear all strokes so you can see what we do right now. We have the image here, I have selected the brush edit mode, and I'm gonna draw where I want the emit of the particles to take place. So I want this side here, and as you can see, I have set my stroke size to 5, the stroke opacity to 1, and the feather amount to 63. So let's go down a little bit now on the Inspector panel. As we can see on the particle controls, I have set it to Bright Luma Threshold to 1, Dark Luma Threshold to 0, Number of Particle Layers 3, and let's click now in the particle, and here is where all the magic happens. The first and the second image, it's gonna be a little bit more simple effect, and on the third one, we're gonna do all the magic that I told you. It's gonna be a more complicated effect that you can create with this tool, and stay tuned because I will analyze it later. So let's go. Particle sizes, we have 18, velocity X minus 18, velocity Y to 0, velocity Z to 0, velocity X randomness to 20, velocity Y randomness to 20, velocity Z randomness to 0, random X bias 0.5, random Y 0.5, random Z 1. Drag amount is to 0, gravity amount to 0, gravity angle X to 0 and the Y as well, gravity angle Z to 270 degrees, birth rate 200, birth rate randomness 40, lifetime 10, all that you can see right now that haven't changed instead of the particle size are the default. Starting opacity and opacity decay 0.1. We're not changing anything there. The random seed, as you see here, we moved it on the right. Continuing particles, it's selected. And then we have clicked on the toggle motion blur, samples 4, and shutter angle 180. Let's see now what these settings are giving to our image. First of all, I'm going to the Inspector panel. I'm unchecking the brush edit mode and hit. And as you can see, we have a disintegrate emit particle effect in our image. As for the second now, the second image, the image with the coffee, again the same tool, but let's go and see now the settings. As you can see on the brush edit mode, I have created the brush in the center of the coffee. The stroke size, it's a little bit bigger now, 1154, and the stroke opacity 1. The bright luma threshold, again, 1, dark luma threshold 0, and number of particle layers 3. And now on the particle. Particle size 10, we change the drag amount to 49, the birth rate to 981, the birth rate randomness to 29, lifetime 246. We have enabled the toggle fade after life. We didn't change anything there. Continuing particles, clicked. And then again on the motion blur, we have enabled the motion blur, samples 4, shutter angle 180. And let's play to see this example. And now, as I said in the beginning of this video, now we're gonna do a little bit more complicated effect. The good thing with the Disintegrate Dual Brush effect is that each layer. So that means that you can combine a lot of layers for different sections of the image, so you can create a more stunning effect on your images. So the first thing again is to add the disintegrate dual brass layer on top of our image. We have created the brass, and let's go now to the settings for the first layer. The bright luma threshold is going to be 1, dark luma threshold 0, number of particle layers 4, and on the particle now we have particle size 2, velocity x minus 10, velocity x randomness minus 5, drag amount 500, and you will see that if you get this to the right, it only allows you to go to 99. So you will select that with double click and type the number 500. It's good for all the values that I'm telling you right now to simply double click on the number and change it to the exact numbers that I have if you want to see the same effect that you're watching on this tutorial. And of course, you can play with any settings so you can match your own desired outcome. Continuing now, gravity amount 0.1, gravity angle Z 135, birth rate 6000, birth rate randomness 100, lifetime 15, toggle fade after life checked, starting opacity 1, opacity decay 0.05, opacity decay randomness 0.1, toggle billboarding is checked, scale decay 0.05, scale decay randomness 0.1. And then we click also on the turbulence controls, and the turbulence displacement is going to be 0, turbulence scale 350, turbulence speed 0.2. Continuing particles is checked, and we haven't enabled the invert animation or the motion blur controls. So let's go and play and see how it looks. As you can see, we're starting to have a very tiny disintegrate emit effect in our image. Now, what we're going to do is to drag this layer, copy it with pressing Alt in our keyboard and then click and bring it above. And now we will change the settings, but we will keep the same brass. And now here is where the things are starting to get a little bit complicated, and what's the solution for that? If you don't have a powerful machine, we're gonna stack a lot of layers of the disintegrate tool brass together for different elements of the image. And that means that the rendering process is gonna need more power. So in order to avoid that, if you don't have a Mac Pro or a 2019 Super Mac, iMac Pro, Mac Pro, and you don't have an external eGPU, what you're going to do is to export each photo with the disintegrate dual brass and then add the copied on top. And you will continue for the second, third, four, five, six, etc. Now again, if you have a strong machine, a very powerful machine, then you can stack all the layers together. So you won't need to do what I'm gonna do right now. So what I'm gonna do is to press the R in my keyboard for the range. I'm gonna select this portion here. I'm gonna go to File, Share, Master File, and export this video. And then I'm gonna wait for it to export. And then I'm gonna have the rendered video that's already have the disintegration of the first layer. I'm gonna drag the copied one. And now on the copied layer, we're gonna have these settings: particle size 4, velocity x minus 7.5, velocity x randomness minus 5. On the drag amount, we're gonna set to 1000, gravity amount 0.1, birth rate 500 this time, birth rate randomness 100, lifetime 15. We're continuing, as you can see here, all you can pause the video so you can write down all the values, scale decay 0.05, and then on the turbulence controls, the turbulence displacement this time is going to be 5, turbulence scale 350, turbulence speed 0.2, and the random seed is going to be 3. And because we are going to need one more layer for the left side of this image, we will wait for it to render, we will export it, and then we will continue with one more layer on top. So basically what we will need to do is to stack multiple disintegration effect layers into our photo. So let's continue and see after we have the second layer rendered, the result is gonna look like this. And then we don't stop here. Again, we're selecting this clip with the R in our keyboard. We export it again. We go into File, Share, Master File Default, and we export the video. Now let's go to the settings of the third layer, the third copy. This is the Gray Tool Brass layer. And as you can see here, I have disabled these layers by pressing V in my keyboard, so I don't have to push the machine to render these files. And let's go here to see what the settings are going to be for the third layer after we have rendered and placed it again. So basically we keep everything the same, and we go to the particle size 6, on the velocity X we place minus 15, then on the drag amount we set it to 1000, on the birth rate we change it to 200, birth rate randomness 200, lifetime 15, and then the opacity decay, I'm gonna set it to 0.02, opacity decay 0.1, and then on the X pin amount, I'm gonna set it to 45, Y spin amount 45, and Z spin amount 45, 0, 0, 0 for the randomness, then on the space decay 0.02, and the space decay randomness 0.05. And then on the turbulence controls, we're gonna set the displacement to 5, the turbulence scale to 350, turbulence speed 0.2, and then all the other things as it is. Now, as soon as I'm going and enable this now, we will have to wait for render, and then we will re-export this file to continue with the other elements of the photo. We will continue with the feed here, but remember to keep all these things. As you can see here on the left, I have kept all the previews, because as I want to move forward for the leg, I'm not gonna place all the settings again, but I'm just gonna change the brass for any other area of the image that I want the emit disintegrate effect to take place. Just think that if you have a strong machine right now, you won't have to do all this process that I'm doing right now with rendering each of the effect layer each time, and you can have them stacked as I'm showing you here right above, so all the effects are going to be rendered on the same time. But because we're not have the cheese grater, the new Mac Pro, we're going to do it that way. So after we finish with the third layer as well, we have the render of the three effects here. And remember that I told you that we need to keep this, so I'm gonna disable the third one, and then I'm gonna start and bring again the first of the layers, as you can see here. And what I'm gonna do different now is gonna click on the brass edit mode on the inspector panel. I'm gonna clear all strokes. So now what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna set the stroke size to 2.5. I have cleared all strokes, as you can see here, and I'm gonna redraw where I want the disintegration effect to take place, on the foot and on the hand. I'm gonna uncheck the brass edit mode, and I have all the settings that I used on the first layer on the previous effect. So basically I'm waiting for it to render, and I'm gonna continue the same process for the second duplicated and the third duplicated layer, so I can have the same effect for the foot and for the hand. And the final result is gonna look like this. I hope you found this video helpful, and if you did, you know what to do. Like this video. If you have any questions, I'm waiting for them in the comment section down below. And also, don't forget to subscribe for more content like this one. Thank you so much for watching. I'm Emilio Takas, and I will see you in the next one.